Hello dear students, in this session let us discuss the topic of solution of linear homogeneous and non-homogeneous PDE with constant coefficients. Okay, solution of linear homogeneous and non-homogeneous PDE with coefficients, that is constant coefficients. So let's start this with a definition of homogeneous as well as non-homogeneous differential equation. So if independent variable is not explicitly occurring in my differential equation, then I will call that differential equation as homogeneous differential equation. Okay, example is dou square z by dou x square plus dou square z by dou y square is equal to 0. This is nothing but homogeneous partial differential equation. Here x and y are independent variables and this is not explicitly occurring in my given partial differential equation. So similarly, for non-homogeneous partial differential equation, I can write dou square z by dou x square plus dou square z by dou y square plus dou z by dou x is equal to xy. So here x and y are my independent variable and which is explicitly occurring in my differential equation. So I will call this differential equation as non-homogeneous partial differential equation. So I can write one more example like dou square z by dou x square plus y into dou square z by dou y square plus x into dou z by dou x is equal to x into e power x. Here also x and y are my independent variable and which is occurring in my differential equation explicitly. So if I consider a general PDE of the form a naught dou n z by dou x power n plus a1 dou n z by dou x power n minus 1 into dou y plus so on up to a n dou n z by dou y power n is equal to f of x comma y. I will call this differential partial differential equation as equation number 1. I can rewrite this equation as a naught d power n plus a 1 d power n minus 1 into d dash plus so on up to a n d dash n which is equal into z which is equal to f of x comma y. This is my equation 2. So here this equation, this particular form is reduced to this form, that is dou, if I split dou power n z by dou x power n minus 1 into dou y as dou power n minus 1 z by dou x power n minus 1 into dou z by dou y. So this is d power n minus 1, that is differential operator with I should differentiate this n minus 1 times into d dash. So d dash is with respect to y, d power n minus 1 is with respect to x. So now I will reduce this equation 2 to f of d comma d dash into z is equal to f of x comma y. Now if this f of d comma d dash is homogeneous in both d and d dash, it should be homogeneous with respect to x as well as with respect to y, then I will call that differential equation as homogeneous partial differential equation. If f of d comma d dash is not homogeneous in d and d dash, then I will call this differential equation as non-homogeneous partial differential equation. So example I can give is dou square z by dou x square plus dou square z by dou y square is equal to x plus y. Look at carefully. X plus y is my f of x comma y. There is no condition for f of x comma y, but my d and d dash, here it is d square, this is d dash whole square. So these two are homogeneous. That means these two is not multiplied, is not a, here independent variable is not explicitly occurring. So d square, d as well as d dash is homogeneous. So I will call this equation as homogeneous partial differential equation. So now to find out the solution of any linear homogeneous or non-homogeneous equation, we usually find the complete solution or general solution. This is a combination of complementary function, plus particular integral. So here complementary function is for left hand side of my equation and particular integral is for right hand side of my equation. If right hand side of the given equation is zero, then there will be no particular integral. So complementary function we will write using we will find out the roots for m and using the condition, that is if m is repeated or m is real and distinct or m is imaginary, for that three different cases there will be three different complementary functions, that is a standard complementary function. So in order to find the auxiliary equation for a given PDE, we will follow the steps. So in ODE, how we were doing, we were having only one independent variable. So in the place of d square, we used to write m square plus m is equal to 1. This is how we used to find out the auxiliary equation, and we were next step will be finding the roots for this m. But in the case of partial differential equation, we will be having more than one independent variable, that is of the form dou square z by dou y square plus dou z by dou x into dou z by dou y is equal to 0. So there will be more independent variables. So here what we will do is we will replace d by m and d dash by 1. Okay, so d will be with respect to x and d dash will be with respect to y. So if I consider my general PDE, equation 2, I can write equation 2 as I will replace d by m and d dash by 1. So my equation 2 becomes a naught m power n plus a1 m power n minus 1 into 1 plus so on up to an. This is d dash, so d dash will be replaced by 1. 1 power n is 1, which is equal to 0. That is to write the auxiliary equation. So this will be a naught m power n plus a1 m power n minus 1 plus so on up to an is equal to 0. Here I will get m1, m2, so on up to mn as a roots for m. So if m1, m2, so on up to mn be distinct roots, then my complementary function will be phi1 y plus m1x plus phi2 y plus m2x plus so on up to phi n y plus mnx. Here this phi1, phi2, so on up to phi n will be arbitrary functions. You can replace phi1 with f1 also, f1 y plus m1 x plus f2 y plus m2 x plus so on up to fn y plus mn x. You can write like this also. You can write like this also. Both are fine. So now let's see if roots are repeated. That is, if m1, m2, so on up to mn repeated say r times. So I will rewrite. So if this is the case, we will write our complementary function as phi 1 y plus m 1 x plus x into phi 2 y plus m 2 x plus so on up to phi n into y plus, oh, repeated r times, so phi r y plus m r x. This will be the complementary function. So, since the roots are repeated, phi 1 y plus mx, sorry, this is x power r minus 1, plus x into phi 2 y plus mx, plus so on up to x power r minus 1, phi r into y plus mrx. So, these are the two cases in the method of finding complementary functions for given partial differential equation. Now let us move to finding particular integral. So here there are three types, that is three ways we can find, sorry, three types of finding the particular integral, that is depending on the value of RHS. So, method of finding particular integral, if the given PDE is of the form d comma d dash of z is equal to f of x comma y, then I can find particular integral as 1 over f of d comma d dash into f of x comma y. Okay. So, here make a note of this. If f of d is of this form into f of x comma y, then I can find out a particular integral as integral of f of x comma c minus lambda x into dx. Here c is equal to y plus lambda x. If you substitute here, you will get f of x comma y itself. So this is one of the note you will use in problems. Now let us see the methods of finding a particular integral. So if the first method is, if f of 1 by f of d comma d dash into x power m into y power n. If f of x comma y is of this form, you will find out particular integral as f of d comma d dash inverse into x power m y power n. So the differential operator you will take to that into numerator, so it will be minus 1, power will be minus 1 into x power m into y power n. Next, what you will do is, you will using binomial expansion, you will expand this function, that is f of d comma d dash, and you will operate that with x power m and y power n. The next type is 1 over f of d comma d dash into e power ax plus by. So if my f of x comma y is in exponential form, then I can find particular integral as e power ax plus by divided by f of a comma b. That is, in the place of d, I will replace the value of a, that is the coefficient of x, and in the place of d dash, I will replace the coefficient of y. Okay. So this is when f of a comma b is not equal to 0. So my denominator should not be equal to 0. If in case my denominator is 0, then what I will do is, if f of a comma b is equal to 0, then I will find particular integral as x into e power ax plus by divided by f dash of a comma b. If f of a comma b is 0, then I should differentiate my f of d comma d dash. Then I should substitute the value of d and d dash, that is a and b, with and also I should multiply x with it. So like that I should find out the particular integral. This is in the case of f dash of ab is not equal to 0. So if again it becomes to 0, then the next step is particular integral will be x square into e power ax plus by divided by f double dash of a comma b. That is, you will differentiate f of d comma d dash twice, then you will substitute the value of d and d dash and you will multiply x square to that. That is the method to find out the particular integral. So you will continue similar procedure if you get denominator is 0 here also. So this is provided f double dash of a comma b is not equal to 0. Okay, so now let's see the third case, that is 1 over f of d square d d dash d dash square into sine of ax plus by. If your right hand side of the equation is in trigonometric form, that is in sine or cos form, you can find out particular integral as, you will replace d square by minus a square, d d dash by minus ab, and d dash square by minus b square into sine of ax plus by. So similarly, if it is a cos ax plus by, here it will be cos of ax plus by. That's all. Nothing will change in this case. Again, this is true only when f of minus a square minus ab minus b square is not equal to 0. If you get this as 0, you will follow the same procedure as in the case of exponential. So in order to understand the concept completely, let's solve some problems based on complementary function as well as particular integral. First problem is d square plus dd dash minus 6 d dash square into z is equal to x plus y. So now I should find out the complementary function as well as particular integral. Since my RHS part is not equal to 0, there will be a particular integral. So let's find out auxiliary equation first. So what I will do, I will replace d by m and d dash by 1. So what I will get, m square plus m minus 6 is equal to 0. If I factorize this, I will get m value as minus 3 comma 2. So now roots are distinct. So let's find write the complementary function, that is cf, as phi 1 y minus 3x plus phi 2 y plus 2x. So complementary function is done. Next, I have to find out the particular integral. So particular integral will be 1 over d square plus dd dash minus 6 d dash square into x plus y. So my RHS part of partial differential equation is of type 1, that is 1 over f of d comma d dash into x power m into y power n form. This I can rewrite as x power 1 into y power 0 plus x power 0 into y power 1. So this is of the form type 1. So what I have to do here, I should write f of d comma d dash whole inverse into x power m into y power n. Then I should write the binomial expansion. I should expand this term using binomial expansion. Then I should operate d terms and d dash terms on my x power m and y power n. Let's follow the similar procedure here. Since there is no binomial expansion of this form, I will rewrite this differential equation into this form so that I can write binomial expansion for 1 plus x power minus 1. Here x will be d dash by d minus 6 d dash square by d square. So what I have done is I have taken d square outside. So 1 plus d dash by d minus 6 d dash square by d square into x plus y as it is. So I can write this as 1 over d square as it is, 1 plus d dash by d minus 6 d dash square by d square whole inverse into x plus y. Here I have expanded this and the next terms will be of higher order. So if I differentiate x plus y with respect to higher orders, I will get 0. So I just write 1 over d square. I have neglected the higher orders. You just understand like that. I have neglected the higher orders. So what I will get, I will multiply x plus y with this x plus y minus d dash means differentiating this operator with respect to y. So if I differentiate this with respect to y, this will be 0, this will be 1. So 1 over d as it is into 1. So now what I will what I have got, 1 over d square into x plus y minus 1 by d into 1, isn't it? So now 1 over d square as it is x plus y. If I differentiate 1 with respect to x, 1 over d is nothing but integration. So I should integrate 1 with respect to x. So if I integrate 1 with respect to x, I will get x 1 over d square into x plus y minus x. X and x gets cancelled. So now 1 over d square into y. This means I should integrate y with respect to x twice because it is d square. So 1 over d into, if I integrate y with respect to